My name is Mridul and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys another one of those DIY party throwing videos. I've done two of those in the past. The first one was like a DIY surprise Christmas party and the second one was a DIY farewell party like under 200 rupees. I will link all of those in the description box below. But for today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you how I, with a couple of my other friends, threw a surprise Harry Potter themed party. Now, step one is to figure out like the main area where you're going to be doing it. So for me, it's always this one part of my room. So we started off by taking off all the decoration from the previous party and setting up the new decoration. Basically, you want to create like a blank canvas where you can put your new creations on top of, if that makes any sense. So what I like to do usually is I like to get like a plain white double bed sheet and use wooden clips in order to hang those on the wall. I like to have a white canvas because it just makes everything look a lot bigger and cleaner and more sharp, I guess. Alright, so once we were done setting up the whole white bed sheet and making like a white canvas, we started off by making the house banners. So the first thing that we did is we grabbed some yarn. We decided to use some jute yarn because it gave kind of like a rustic look, but you can obviously use whatever you have at home, like a ribbon or even a rope. After which we grabbed some black chart paper and cut out these house banner bases. I will leave the dimensions in the description box below, but basically we needed one chart paper for each house. And finally, coming to the house logos, I printed them off of Google and I used an X-Acto knife in order to get a precise cut. A scissor will not work. I've tried it already. The silhouette of these houses is very complicated, which is why I would suggest using an X-Acto knife or a cutter. Especially Gryffindor is very, very difficult to cut. Ravenclaw was very easy. But yeah, basically you have to cut it out and then just simply stick it on to the black chart paper. And I think it looks quite nice. Now the house banners on their own did look pretty cool, kind of like a backdrop for taking pictures, but in order to add like that extra zing, I thought it would be perfect to add those floating candles that you see in like almost every DIY Harry Potter theme party. And I will admit making these floating candles is a little bit complex, but trust me, it's so worth it. It really adds that really cool touch. So yeah, this is how we made the floating candles. Now the first thing that you need is a plain white paper. I will leave the dimensions in the description box below. And the second thing that you will need are these battery operated lights. Next, grab some hot glue gun and simply just stick the battery operated lights on top of the paper. Once you're done with that, line the paper with some hot glue gun again and roll out the paper so that it looks kind of like a candle. Use some hot glue gun again to secure the edges. And this is what the basic structure of the candle will look like. Next, we're going to work on the hanging part of the candle. So you'll need a needle and some thread. We decided to use the transparent thread, but you can of course use whatever color thread you desire to. All you need to do is, with the help of a needle, you need to poke through the candle from one side to the other and kind of form this sort of triangle. This is the best way that I've found that the candle will stay vertical and not go horizontal once you hang it. Now the DIY that we've made does look like a candle, but to make it look a little bit more realistic, we're going to use some hot glue gun and line the rim of the candle with a lot of hot glue gun and then just kind of hold it vertically and let the glue flow, kind of mimicking the look of real wax. The next step is an optional step and it is to paint the candle white. Now since the hot glue gun was transparent, I wanted the entire candle to be of one color, so I painted the entire thing white. And yeah, just repeat these steps 20 more times and you'll have a wall full of floating candles. Now how we hung these candles on the ceiling is we got some double-sided hooks from Crawford Market. They were very, very sturdy and that is basically how we decided to hang our floating candles. Now, if you're planning to throw this party in your bedroom, I'm sure you'll have a mirror somewhere. So what we decided to do is we got these printouts of these wanted posters. I'll leave the picture in the description box below so that you can print it out for yourself as well. So what I would recommend is to just print one out and then Xerox the rest. I Xeroxed like, I think 20 of those, and it's so cheap. I got them for like 10 rupees, 20 copies for 10 rupees. And we just ended up sticking the printouts all over the mirror. As you can see, it looked really cool and it kind of gave that, you know, black and white feel. And on the actual mirror, I just grabbed a red lipstick and just wrote on the mirror to kind of give an illusion of like blood dripping through the mirror, I guess. But yeah, that is what we were going for. Moving on to like the food and prop station. You will need two things for this DIY. The first one is some brown paint, and the second thing is a rectangular sponge, which is like a perfect size to mimic the shape of a brick. So basically you want to submerge the sponge into the paint and just stamp it onto the cloth. Now the first thing that you want to remember is not to stamp on the sponge right underneath the first row. Basically, you want to leave some sort of gaps. I don't know if I'm doing a good job at explaining it, but you can see in the video, it's not right underneath the first stamping, and this is what it finally looks like. Now, the second thing that you should remember is to place some sort of newspaper underneath the cloth. Otherwise, this is what will happen to your tiles. The paint will seep through the cloth, and yeah, this is what it'll look like. And once the brick wall was ready, we just hung it onto the wall. Of course, do it how it's convenient to you, to your place. But yeah, this is what it finally looks like. So once we got the brick wall into position, it was time to make some props. I didn't have that many props. I had like two or three props. The first one is this spell book. Honestly, it's just so easy. You just need to grab like a thick book. I got like an encyclopedia, and on top of that, I printed out a cover. I will again link the picture in the description box below in case you want to print it out. You print it out and you stick it on top of the book. It looks like a spell book. Now, prop number two is this magical drink. Again, as simple as it sounds, you just need to go and grab any sort of drink that you want. I decided to pick up this Jiru bottle because I love Jiru. If you like Pepsi, you can pick up Pepsi. If you like Mirinda, I got the banner printed out. You stick them on and it looks like magical water, magical drink. And the last thing that I placed on the food station was actually the only food item. You want to start off with a piece of cardboard that looks like the shape of a leaf, and you want to fold it in half and hot glue gun the center of it, not all the way, just halfway through. You will need a toothpick, just stick half of it, leave the other half of the toothpick out and just press it into half. And this is what one of the wing will look like. Next, grab a pair of scissors and just cut the circumference of the semicircle to get a similar texture of the wings. You want to do this entire process one more time and then grab some sort of round chocolate. I got a Ferrero Rocher. You can use, of course, whatever you want, and just poke it through on either sides of the chocolate. And yeah, this is what it finally looks like. Can't be a Harry Potter party without DIY Harry Potter wands. And this is how I made them. It's actually pretty easy, you will see. Now, the first thing that you're gonna need are these wooden skewers. They're usually used in the kitchen for barbecues, but we're gonna use three of those in order to make our wands. And the next thing that you want is a hot glue gun. Basically, the first thing that you're gonna try to do is try to kind of stick these three together to make the base of the wand. So I'm just going in a circular motion, covering all the sides of these wooden sticks and kind of binding them together. You want to add the hot glue gun, hold the sticks together for a couple of seconds, add the glue again and hold it again. You want to keep doing this process for a couple of times until you feel like the three sticks have become one. After I'm done making sure that the wand is sturdy, I like to do these circular motions all over the wand. This is what it looks like. Basically, you just want to do this all over the wand. You want to make the base thinner as compared to the top. And what I like to do is I like to make kind of like a circle on top, kind of like a bulge at the head of the wand. So I feel like the messier you are, the better it looks. You don't need to be very neat with it because you're gonna end up painting it anyways. And And the last and the most important thing is the outfit. This is like a detailed look of what I wore, and also I decided to show you like a male perspective because I'm sure there'll be guys and girls both at the party. So yeah, I just wanted to give you like an option for each. Now, I started off by wearing this dress which has like a really beautiful leather skirt underneath, but of course the top doesn't match. So I wore this white shirt on top of the dress which I got from Hill Road for ₹100. I've showed it in one of my hauls before. And just button about three of the first buttons, and the bottom part of the shirt I just like to grab behind me, and using a rubber band I just tie it up at the back. Now if you're wearing like an actual skirt you could obviously tuck it in, but since I am wearing a dress I have nowhere to tuck it in. Now for the cloak, we rented out these graduation coats. This coat was perfect because it was lined with a red ribbon, and I wanted to be in the house Gryffindor, so it was perfect, the red lining. So yeah, basically just wear this on top of the entire outfit. And then we got these ties. We just got some felt and cut out the shape of a tie. And at the back, we used some hot glue gun to stick some bobby pins or just normal tic-tac pins so that you could secure it on the collar. And yeah, this is what the entire costume looks like from head to toe. I also decided to add these knee-high socks to kind of complete the look. Now the costume for the boys is exactly the same, white shirt, black pants and the cloak on top. But one thing that we did do a little bit differently is we got some colorful ribbons. Now for Hufflepuff, we grabbed some yellow ribbon and lined the neckline to kind of symbolize that he belongs to the house Hufflepuff, if that makes any sense. Alright, those were my DIYs for an epic Harry Potter party. If you happen to DIY any of these, or you happen to throw a Harry Potter party yourself, don't forget to tag me in your pictures. I would love to see your recreations. And I really, really hope you guys found this video helpful and also enjoyed watching it. If you did, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, and follow me on my social medias. I'll see you really soon in my next video. Bye!